probably the first conservatory in history, right around 800, was established in Andalusia in Cordoba in 822. The sort of leader of the school is best known as Zari, which means blackbird. That was his nickname, because he has jet black hair. Came from Baghdad, bringing music theory to Spain. One of the features is this splitting of the melody the way they've done. It doesn't fit a sort of mathematical sequence. It's more intuitive, more spontaneous. Pattern notes, syncopated rhythms. Those predate Islam. The early music focused on vocals by servant women called Kinan. These women put traditional Arab poetry to music. And poetry is a pretty important element in Arab culture and Persian culture. And in fact, the Quran itself is written in verse. And it makes sense in an oral tradition to have things written poetically. I guess I've said enough to Mr. Butler in some ways. To be able to remember lots of information. And so the music was really initially a support of poetry and oral tradition, but then evolved in different directions, instrumental and such. And of course, this would rub off on folks in Spain over a 700-year period. So if you listen to some of traditional flamenco music, I think you will hear all sorts of different parallels with syncopated rhythms, the intention that they use, and the phrasing itself. So if we could just now switch to flamenco, a couple of clips from that. These influences can be traced in other types of music, including American jazz. I certainly would want to end this off with something from Miles Davis, in behind here. Miles Davis's most famous album is called Kind of Blue, which he recorded in 1961-62. And he kind of snuck a song onto that album called Flamenco Sketches. And if you just sort of listened to it and didn't know a lot about his career, you'd say it's just a jazz song. It plays around with the ideas that he learned simultaneously while working on this album called Sketches of Spain, where they went to Spain, did the research on the types of music that we've been talking about, and tried to meld that together, orchestral work, and blend it with jazz, and sort of really open up a whole new avenue for jazz musicians. So if we could, Soldia, which is not really a traditional, but, plays the same role as the guitar in the traditional music. Call to prayer, maybe, I don't know. Since it came out in 1962, this album has never been out of print. It sells about 20 to 100,000 copies every year. Which means younger generations are trying to figure out what this guy Miles Davis is all about, but also the sort of exploring how the mingling of cultures goes on. And now I'll turn it over to Mr. Butler. Thank you very much.